Hi, hello guys, this is Vijay, chemistry lecturer from Alibaba Junior College. And as you know that we have started our NEET series, based on that we are discussing about NEET chemistry and NEET biology. And in that category, today we are going to discuss about NEET chemistry unit 2 atomic structure in detail. Let's start. So the next topic we are going to discuss about is emission spectrum of hydrogen atom and Rydenberg equation. So let us discuss in detail. So emission spectrum of hydrogen atom. See, the spectrum of the hydrogen atom, you know, that can be obtained by passing an electric discharge through the gas taken in the discharge tube under the low pressure, and this emitted light, which is analyzed with the help of the spectroscope. So in the earlier topic, we discussed about how this the hydrogen gas we have taken for in the discharge tube under low pressure, when the light which is emitted, and that could be analyzed with the help of the spectroscope. Okay, and this spectrum, the hydrogen spectrum, which consisting of large number of lines which are appearing with different regions of wavelength. They have different wavelength with different regions. Some of these lines which are present in the visible region, while some of the other region that could be seen in the ultraviolet UV region and also infrared IR region. Okay. So in the year 1885, J.J. Palmer, who developed a simple relationship among the different wavelength of the series of the visible lines present in the hydrogen spectrum, and what relationship he could expressed. Okay. So in the year 1885, J.J. Palmer, who developed a simple relationship among the different wavelength and frequencies of the series of the visible line present in the hydrogen spectrum with the help of this equation. Now, speed of the light by meter is equal to 109677 into 1 by 2 square minus 1 by n square. Let us discuss about all these components present in this equation, and how far this this equation helping for to find out the other different wavelength of the series present in the hydrogen spectrum. So here the n, which is considered to be what, that is said to be an integral equal or the greater, which is greater than that number 3, that is n is equal to 3, 4, 5, and it goes on. Okay, and this is known as Palmer formula. So according to the Palmer formula, we are using for the integral value for n that is greater than number 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, that goes on. Okay, and this Palmer formula that could gives only for the spectral lines which is present in the visible region, and these series of lines which appear in the visible region, and this particular region is considered to be Palmer series or Palmer region. Okay, so this is considered to be what, Palmer region or Palmer series. Okay, as this the Palmer series, which was discovered after that, a series of spectral lines of the hydrogen atom in different regions were discovered, and these lines which are present in different region, and they were grouped into 5 different series of lines, and these 5 different series of lines are commonly known as Lyman series, Palmer series, Pasjean series, Brackett series, and Pfund series. So these are the 5 different series of region or series of lines. Okay, so Lyman series, Palmer series, Pasjean series, Brackett series, and Pfund series. Okay, so among these all, you see the Lyman series, which is appearing in the UV region. Lyman series, which is appearing in the UV region, and the Palmer series, which is appears in the visible region. Palmer series, which is there in the visible region, and the other 3 lines which are present in the IR region. So these 3 are said to be present in the IR region. So these are the 3 different regions where these 5 different series could be discovered. Okay. Now talking about this Rydenberg equation. So according to this equation, you see, as the other series of these hydrogen spectral lines which were discovered, a more general expressions that could be found as, you know, 1 by lambda is equal to V bar in centimeter per one, and this value, you know, this value is considered to be R, and this is called as Rydenberg equation. So according to this, you see where the n1 and the n2, which are considered to be the integers, so these both are considered to be integers. No, the n1 and n2, these both are considered to be the integers where the n2 is greater than the n1. Okay, and here this R, the value of this R, which is considered to be Rydenberg constant, and the value is 109677 centimeter per centimeter. Okay, and this expression is found to be valid for all the lines which is present in the hydrogen spectrum, and this equation is called as a Rydenberg equation. So for the given spectral series n1, which remains constant, while the n2 that varies as n1 plus 1 and n1 plus 2 and n1 plus 3, and it goes on. Okay, here the n1 value which remains constant, whereas the n2 value that is going to be, you know, changing according to the value, like n1 plus 1, n1 plus 2 and n1 plus 3, it goes on. Okay, for example, like Lyman series, let us talk about Lyman series. If you see the n1 value which is considered to be 1, whereas the n2 value that is going to be, you know, 2 3 4 5, and goes on. And for example, like Palmer series, you see the n1 value that is considered to be 2, whereas the n2 value that is considered to be 3 4 5, and it goes on. So likewise, the rest of the series which is appearing, the changing of the n2 value. Okay, so if you look at this table of this hydrogen spectra of different series, and you can able to understand in detail about the different regions of this different series along with the n1 value as well as the n2 value. Okay, so this is according to this hydrogen atom, whereas the hydrogen like ions are those which contain only one electron, say for example like helium, lithium, etc. No, helium, lithium, these are also could be expressed by the Rydenberg equation, like the hydrogen like ions. So that could be expressed by 1 by lambda is equal to V bar, and the Rydenberg value that is nothing but R into 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square, 1 by n1 square minus 1 by n2 square. Okay, and z square, that is nothing but atomic number. Okay, so where the Z, which is said to be the nuclear charge, that is equal to the atomic number, and R is considered to be the Rydenberg constant. And for example, for these, you know, hydrogen like ions like helium, lithium, that this Rydenberg equation could be expressed in this way. Now let us discuss in detail about how far this different series could be possible. For example, when the electron which is jumps from all the energy levels which is higher than n is equal to 1 and n is equal to 2 3 4 5, then the energy level n is equal to 1 energy level, the lines which is obtained fall in the ultraviolet region, and these lines are considered to be Lyman series. Similarly, the lines which is obtained when the electron which is jumps to the second energy level, you know, that is called as n is equal to 2 from the higher energy level, then n is equal to 3 4 5 6, which falls in the visible region, and these particular regions are considered to be Palmer series. And it is in a similar manner, the transition from the higher energy level that is equal to n is equal to 3, which produces passing series. Similarly, bracket and Pfund series, which is corresponding for n value that is equal to 4 and n value which is equal to 5. So in that manner, the energy levels which is considered to be. The generation of this spectral series in the hydrogen spectrum could be explained by looking into this chart. So if you look at this, you can easily understand, no, the different energy levels, say for example N1 and N2, and how far it varies from all the different type of the series. So look at this picture, you can easily understand that. So now talking about angular momentum. Okay, as we know that linear momentum, that is the product of mass and linear velocity. Yes, so according to the linear momentum, P is equal to mv. Yes, linear momentum is nothing but P is equal to mv. It is a product of mass of the substance and the velocity of the substance or the body. Similarly, angular momentum, which is the product of the momentum of the inertia I and the angular velocity omega. Okay, inertia of I and inertia of the body, the moment of the inertia of the body and the angular velocity, that is equal to omega. Okay, for an electron of the mass m which is moving in a circular path of the radius r around the nucleus, the angular momentum is equal to I into omega, since I is equal to mr square and omega, which is equal to v by r, where the v is the linear velocity and r is the radius of the circular path. Okay, so here the angular momentum is considered to be, so it is a circular path where the electron which is moving around the nucleus. Okay, so the angular momentum of this particular the electron which is revolving around the nucleus, that is equal to I into omega. Okay, so here I is nothing but what? Okay, so I is nothing but mr square. Mr square is nothing but, here m is considered to be mass of the electron and r is said to be radius of the circular path. Similarly, for the omega, that is equal to v by r, v is nothing but velocity of the, the speed of the electron or the substance which is around the circular path, and r is considered to be the radius of the circular path. Okay, therefore angular momentum, when we are writing for angular momentum, that is mvr is equal to, angular momentum mvr, okay, so angular momentum mr squared, that is equal to m is nothing but mass of the electron and r is nothing but radius of the circular path, into v by r, that is v is nothing but velocity of the electron and r is nothing but radius of the circular path. So that is equal to mvr. Mvr is nothing but angular momentum of the electron. Okay, so here m is mass of the electron and v is the linear velocity, and also r is nothing but the radius of the circular path. Okay, so this is a simple representation for angular momentum when talking about the difference between momentum and angular momentum, and this will help us for solving few problems from this chapter. Yes, so far guys, we have discussed a few topics from this unit 2 atomic structure in detail, and this particular chapter we will continue with one more video. Until then, thank you guys.